Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ambal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 8 on Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to discuss the isentropic flow in nozzle and diffuser, part 4. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the area as a function of Mach number, impulse function ratio, and mass flow rate through nozzle and diffuser in isentropic flow. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the flow characteristics in nozzle and diffuser. And the learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the flow characteristics in CD nozzle, convergent divergent nozzle. The student will be able to explain the flow characteristics in the convergent nozzle, and the student will be able to explain the flow characteristics in the diffuser. And this is the diagrammatic representation of the flow through convergent nozzle. So in the first diagram, we have a convergent nozzle which is connected between the reservoir and the exhaust chamber. So the fluid condition at the reservoir is stagnation condition. The temperature is TO, density is rho 1, pressure is PO. And the exhaust chamber, the pressure is PB, so back pressure. And we can regulate the flow in the outlet using some gate valve. And the pressure in the nozzle exit is represented by PE, exit pressure of the nozzle. Now initially, we take the flow characteristics are explained with the help of a curve A, B, C, D, E and F. The curve A is the horizontal line from the inlet to the exit of the nozzle, and the corresponding characteristics, the exit pressure divided by stagnation pressure ratio, is given by the curve at the top, and the mass flow characteristics is given by the curve at the bottom. The curve A, point A, where PE by PO equal to 1, that means the exit pressure is equal to the stagnation pressure, and we have a horizontal line. So PE equal to PO, that is why we have the horizontal line. And the point B and C, the pressure ratio decreases. So PE by PO value is less than 1, but it is higher than the critical pressure ratio 0.528. So 0.528 is the critical pressure ratio for the convergent nozzle for gamma equal to 1.4, that is air. And here B and C, look at the curve. So the pressure decreases up to the exit, and it goes to the exhaust chamber. So the pressure, exit pressure, is higher than the back pressure. The pressure is higher than the back pressure. That is what PE by PO, point P, B and C. Point D, that is curve D. So by regulating the flow, by regulating mass flow rate, so we can, by increasing the, in particular, actually increasing the mass flow rate, the curve D is for the critical pressure ratio PE by PO equal to 0.528. So corresponding value is here. This is the point D. So where the mass flow rate is maximum. The mass flow rate is maximum. And further, so you look at the A, the mass flow rate is minimum. By increasing the flow rate, we have the point B where the pressure ratio is less. By increasing the flow rate further, again the pressure ratio reduces and the mass flow rate increases. At the critical point, at the critical pressure ratio 0.528, the mass flow rate is maximum. Then the mass flow rate remains constant. Remaining part of the flow regulation, the mass flow rate remains constant, and the PE by PO value, that is also remains, it is horizontal. There is no change. Now look at the curve D and the E. So this is the point exit pressure. Now the exit pressure is low, but the back pressure is high. So what happens? The fluid is adjusting to the exit pressure by means of shock wave. So this is the shock wave occur in the exhaust chamber to adjust the pressure. So this is the explanation for the flow characteristics of a convergent nozzle. We have to write in terms of words. So the convergent nozzle is connected between the reservoir where the fluid at the stagnation condition and exhaust chamber where pressure is PB. So the convergent nozzle connected between exhaust chamber and the reservoir where the fluid properties are stagnation condition. Curve A, P equal to PO. So we said curve A equal to P equal to PO, we will get a horizontal line. Curve B and C, the pressure ratio PE by PO is more than the critical pressure ratio PB by PO. So that is 0.5 to A is the critical pressure ratio for gamma equal to 1.4. And the curve D, the pressure ratio equal to critical pressure ratio 0.5 to A. So that the characteristic also we have explained. Curve E and F, PE is greater than PB. The exit pressure is higher than the back pressure. The pressure ratio is less than the critical pressure ratio. So the change in the pressure occurs in the nozzle by forming the shock wave. That is what it is given here. Shock wave is forming to adjust the pressure. The shock wave occurs only in the exhaust chamber in the case of convergent nozzle. The next, the flow through the convergent divergent nozzle. So here again we have a reservoir where the properties are stagnation properties PO, TO and ρO, the properties stagnation pressure, stagnation temperature and stagnation density. And we have the exhaust chamber where the back pressure PB is the back pressure and the exit pressure is PE. Exit pressure is given by the PE and we have the throat section. We have the convergent nozzle and we have a throat section, then we have the divergent nozzle. Now, what is expected in the convergent divergent nozzle? So, the nozzle always acting as a accelerating device. The flow velocity will increase always from inlet to the exit of the nozzle. So, by adjusting the flow, initially we have the 1, the mass flow rate is minimum, slowly we are increasing the mass flow rate. So, for the horizontal line, the mass flow rate is 0, there is no flow rate. Now, when the pressure mass flow rate is changed, when value is changed for point A, corresponding curve is A. Now, what happens? So, look at here, the pressure decreases in the convergent portion and here this is the throat section and then the pressure is increasing. So, the pressure decreases, that is what expected from the nozzle, and then pressure increases, that is not expected from the nozzle because it is a convergent divergent nozzle. But the diverging portion is acting as a diffuser. So, the pressure increases, that means that it is acting as a diffuser. Similarly, point B, further increase the flow rate. Point B, we have the curve B. Here again, the convergent portion is acting as a nozzle. Then the divergent portion is acting as a diffuser because there is increase in the pressure. So, decrease in pressure and increase in velocity is what expected. But in the diverging portion, it is acting as a diffuser. The curve C, it is for throat Mach number equal to 1. So, Mach number equal to 1, right? So, curve C. So, up to throat, the Mach number is 1. Then again, it is acting as a diffuser. So, curve C is also after the throat section, again it is acting as a diffuser. The pressure is increasing. Then, curve point D, that is curve D. If you take curve D, from starting from here, up to throat, it is converging nozzle. It is acting as a nozzle. Then, for some portion of the diverging portion, it is again acting as a nozzle where Mach number equal to 1. So, velocity is increasing. But after that, the pressure is increasing. So, the pressure raise, actually Mach number become 1 and there is a shock wave. So, in the diverging portion, there is a shock wave. In the convergent divergent nozzle, in the diverging portion, there is a shock wave. After the shock wave, the Mach number decreases and the pressure increases. So, the shock wave, we discuss the flow characteristics or the calculation of the shock wave in a separate chapter. But in the divergent portion of the nozzle, there is a possibility of forming the shock wave because of the off-design condition. And similarly for point E, so the nozzle, the diverging portion is acting as a nozzle further extended and then it is again acting as a diffuser. So, in the entire discussion, the curve H is the design condition. The curve H, you look at the curve H, it is for the designed value of the nozzle. Then we have F and G and I and J. So, F and G, I and J, again, so up to the exit pressure, so the up to the exit of the nozzle, so the flow act as a, it is acting as a nozzle, but there is pressure difference. The pressure difference is adjusted within the exhaust chamber. By means of a shock wave. So, these are all the shock wave which is occurring in the exhaust chamber. So, we have number of curve. For each curve, we have the mass flow rate setting for the corresponding mass flow rate. So, the curves represents the the flow characteristics, and the curve H, the line H is what's design value. All the other condition of operation are, they are called as off-design condition, off-design flow characteristics of the convergent divergent nozzle. So we have to write the sentences. For curve A and B, the flow is accelerating up to the throat and then decelerating in the diverging portion is acting as a diffuser. So A and B, it is acting as a diffuser. Curve C, the Mach number at the throat is unity 1, the critical condition, and the pressure is still increasing in the divergent portion. So up to the throat it is acting as a nozzle, then it is acting as a diffuser. Curve H corresponds to the design value of the back pressure. So it is what design value, design condition of the nozzle. Curve D and E, it is supersonic expansion, takes place in some portion of the divergent part, the fluid adjusts to the back pressure by the shock wave. Curve F and G, the supersonic expansion extended in the exit of the nozzle, but still adjusted to its condition in the exhaust chamber. Curve I and J, this is the back pressure is lower than the nozzle exit pressure and the fluid adjusts its condition in the exhaust chamber. So these are all the explanation for the different curves which demonstrates the flow characteristics of the converging diverging nozzle. Then flow through the diffuser. So the design of diffuser, it is more complicated than the design of nozzle, because in the converging diverging diffuser, so the diffuser is normally expected to convert the supersonic flow in the subsonic flow. So the supersonic flow, the fluid enters in the supersonic condition the diffuser and leaves in the subsonic condition. So throughout the diffuser the flow is decelerated, the pressure is increased. By decreasing the velocity, pressure is increased. That is what expected in the case of a diffuser. So there are two types of diffusion. One we call it as isentropic diffusion, and there is irreversibility, non-isentropic diffusion. So isentropic diffusion, it is what design condition. So Mach number is greater than 1 up to the throat and Mach number is less than 1. So the flow is continuously decelerating and the pressure increases. In the case of when you have irreversibility, when you have a shock wave, when you have irreversibility due to the shock wave, so the shock wave occurs normally in the diverging part of the diffuser, and the Mach number, there is a drastic pressure rise across the shock wave that we will discuss later in the subject. So Mach number is greater than 1 in the converging diffuser and Mach number is less than 1 in the diverging diffuser. So these three flow characteristics you have to be familiar and you have to write you have to draw the diagram and you have to write in simple sentences about the flow characteristics in the nozzle and the diffuser. And this is the gas table by S.M. Yahya. This table will be using for solving the problem in the rest of the chapters in the subject. And this subject, this part of the syllabus, isentropic flow in the variable air duct, or isentropic, generally isentropic flow, we will be referring to the table 3.1, 3.2 and 3.3. So isentropic flow of perfect gases. 3.1, it gives the data for gamma equal to 1.3, and table 3.2, it gives the data for gamma equal to 1.4, and table 3.3, it gives the data for the gamma equal to 1.67. And this is the sample table for gamma equal to 1.4. The first column is the Mach number. So normally we take the properties with respect to Mach number or any given parameter. Sometimes you will be given the static to stagnation temperature ratio. Based on that value, you have to take the other properties. So for a given Mach number, you can read the value horizontally, T by TO, P by PO, A by A star, P by P star, AP by A star PO, everything we can take, and we calculate the unknown parameter in the problem in the case of isentropic flow, and this table is for gamma equal to 1.4. And we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You can refer to the book for additional, for more detailed explanation of the subject and the numerical example. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comment box. So if you have any queries, you can write to me mail ID or WhatsApp number. We will meet again in another lecture on the gas dynamics and jet propulsion. Until then, bye bye.